The question is, a pentagonal prism of base side 50 mm and axis height 70 mm is resting on HP by its base. With the regular simple standing condition, the solid is resting on the horizontal plane, with one of the base edges being parallel to VP. One out of the five base edges in the pentagonal prism, one base edge is maintaining as parallel to the vertical plane. And this solid is cut by a plane which is perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degree to HP. Here comes about the cutting plane. A cutting plane which is perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degree to HP. Inclined at 40 degree to HP is going to cut the solid. Where it is going to cut the solid exactly? The cutting plane meets the axis at the midpoint. At the midpoint of the axis, the cutting plane is going to pass. The total height of the solid is given as 70 mm. So the midpoint may be at the point 35 mm from the base or from the top. So midpoint of the axis, the cutting plane is going to pass. So in this way, you are going to cut the solid, and after cutting the solid, you will have the retained portion only. When you cut the solid, definitely the solid will become two parts, removed portion and retained portion. In that, our concentration is only on the retained portion. The retained portion you need to develop and you have to show it in the paper. So this is what the task here. For that, first you have to draw the orthographic projection of the solid, the front and top views of the solid. Thereafter, you need to develop the solid. After developing the solid, you have to consider the impacts happen due to the intersection of the solid with the cutting plane. Okay, so here for the last few topics, what you learned, you have to use here. You are going to use projections of solids, and then you are going to use sections of solids, and then you are going to use the development of solids concept. So these three concepts you are going to use in this single question. First, you need to follow the projections of solid concept for drawing the front and top views of the solid. After that, you are going to use the sections of solid concept in order to cut the solid with the given cutting plane. After that, you are going to follow the development of surfaces concept to develop the solid. Okay, this is what the work we are going to do here. One by one you have to do. First, you need to draw the solid. After providing the solid only, we can cut the solid. After cutting the solid only, we can develop the solid. So this is nothing but the sequence of operation you have to follow here. First drawing the solid, and then cutting the solid, and then developing the retained portion. In this sequence, you need to work. First, draw the solid. Here the solid condition is simple standing condition. Simple standing condition. Let me to draw the XY line first. Okay. Here, the solid is in a very simple standing condition. So, in which view you will get the base of the solid? The very first check post, where should be the base and how should be the base? In which view you will get the base view of the solid? In front view or in top view? When the solid is standing in the simple vertical position on the horizontal plane. Surely, in the top view only you can see the base view of the solid. Here the base view of the solid is nothing but a pentagon. Simply you are going to saw a pentagon only. So that pentagon need to be drawn in the top view area. Just draw it. So for my convenience, I am using this kind of tools here. But in your paper, you have to do everything with the drafter scale. Okay. The angle of inclusion between the sides of the pentagon is 108 degree. Yes, I just completed drawing the pentagonal base here. How many corners will be in this solid? Very, very chilly questions since you just come out with the projections of solid basics and now we entered with the development of surfaces. In that time, this question is a silly question. However, it is better to ask questions here. So totally 10 number of corners will be there in this pentagonal prism. Base corners 5 and face corners 5. So base corners will be named with the alphabets. It's our rule only. And the face corners may be named with, excuse me. One more time, sir. One just one. It is 4 and it is 5. Now, after naming the corners, we have to project everything into the front view area. The axis height of the solid given is 70 mm. For the height of 70 mm, we can fix the faces. And again, when you are supposed to mark the name in the front view, 5 is 1, 2, 3, and here 4. And finally, here everything is the dash, E dash, A dash, B dash, C dash, and here D dash. Right, the front and top views over, and after that you have to cut the solid. Now we have completed the projection of the solid. The front and top views of the solid is just over. Now we needed to cut the solid with the given cutting plane. The given cutting plane here is the cutting plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degree to HP, and it is going to meet the solid axis at a point center, at a midpoint. So just aim that point first. The axis is actually going just behind this 4 dash D dash edge. Okay. That's why we are need not to show the axis with the proper axis line format here. Why I didn't show the axis here? Because the axis is just behind the vertical edge 4 dash D dash. So I not showed the axis here. But the axis is there. In the axis at a height of 35 mm, because at the midpoint, we need to aim the cutting plane passing. So just to measure it, and at the midpoint, we need to make the cutting plane to pass over the solid. The cutting plane nature is 40 degree inclined to HP. So in that, you can measure 40 degree inclination. and then draw the cutting plane. Draw the cutting plane through the lateral portion of the solid. Just leave these two marks in order to authorize this as a cutting plane. Okay. So this is nothing but our cutting plane. The portion above the cutting plane is considered as the removed portion, and the portion below the cutting plane is considered as the retained portion. Okay. This is nothing but our retained portion. Why I from the beginning drawn all the solid edges with a very mild sketch only? Because after cutting the solid only, we will know which is the retained portion and which will be the removed portion. So now we know what is actually the retained portion. This portion only, the retained portion. So just darken the edges, which are all comes under the retained portion only. Okay. See here, this portion is only the retained portion. I need to darken it. So from the beginning we completed everything with the help of the 2H pencil. At the time when you identified these portions are nothing but the retained portion, then only you need to use the HB pencil for redrawing or darkening the portions. And the cutting plane is also need to be drawn with that HB pencil. So this is nothing but our retained portion. Not only we need to darken the retained portion. See, due to the attack of the cutting plane, new terminals will be obtained. In former, 1-5 is nothing but the starting point ending and ending point of the particular edge. But now this cutting plane sectioned this edge. It made this edge two parts. It just shortened the edge. So instead of 5-, now we got a new terminal of this longer edge. See, all the lateral edges, side edges are equal in length in this solid before sectioning. But after sectioning, each and every side edges will have separate length because of the nature of the cutting plane. The cutting plane here cut the solid inclined to the base. So see, all the longer edges are having different length. So the longer edge 1-5 now become this much height only. So this ending terminal need to be named with a different word. See, here already we are having 5-. Here you can have 5-1-. Okay. 5-1-. And the same way 1-A is now not 1-A. This end up with this length. So this new terminal of A-1 can be named with 1-1-. Okay. In the same way here, 4-D-. This point can be named as 4-1-. In the same way here, 2-B-- is nothing but 2-1-. And finally, 3-C-- is nothing but here. From here, you need to start 3-1-. So in this way, after sectioning the solid, you need to identify the newly obtained terminals. In order to identify the newly obtained terminals, just start to travel from any extreme of your cutting plane. See, I am starting from here and start to travel. First one intersection, it is 5-1-. Only one edge is intersecting, so only one cut point. In the same way, 1-A-1-1-. 4-D-4-1-. 2-B-2-1-B-. 3-C-. 3-1-, and C-. In this way, these are all nothing but newly formed terminals of each and every edges. Okay. After marking them, now only you can project these corners into your top view area. Since it is a prism, there is no hard effort you need to take in order to mark the cut points in the top view. Simply at the actual place you can mark them. See here, you can get 5-1. And here 1-1, and there 2-1, and here 3-1, and finally here 4-1. In the case of prism, it is very easy to mark the cut points from the top view to the from the front view to the top view. we marked. Now the portion is over up to sections of solid concept. Hereafter you need to develop the solid. Okay, for that as usual it is actually a prism, pentagonal prism. So which method you can follow for developing this? You can go for the parallel line method. Okay, parallel line method. In the first step in the parallel line method is you need to draw two stretch out lines from the top extreme and the bottom extreme of your front view. Okay, for the bottom stretch out line, just you can extend your xy line, that's enough. And for the top stretch out line, you need to draw a horizontal line from the range of the face of the solid. Yes, but you should not make this bottom stretch out line and xy line to merge with each other. Just have some gap. Here you can mark y, leave some gap, and then you can have the bottom stretch out line and the top stretch out line, and close it in one side first. Close it in one side first, and then you need to have the various segments, number of segments based on the nature of the solid. Here it is a pentagonal prism, so 5 segments you need to have. Five segments you need to have, 5 base sides. With equal to the base edge length of the solid, here you can mark this, each segments. This is nothing but development of the uncut solid. Without cutting the pentagonal prism, I developed it. Okay, I didn't consider the sectioning as of now. And then mark the names starting from A, B, C, D, E, and you have to end up with A. From A you have started and you have to end with A. And the same here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you end up with 1. So this is nothing but the uncut solid development. Now you are going to consider the cut points. And before mark the cut points here, just to note down the address of each and every cut point. See, who are all the actually the cut points? 5, 1, 1, 1, 4, 1, 2, 1, and 3, 1. Just have a note, what is the address of these cut points? That is 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1 and 5, 1, where these cut points are actually existing. So the 1, 1 is existing A1 long range. In the A1 long range, we are having 1, 1. In the same way, the 2, 1, 1 is existing B2. So B2 long range is nothing but the address for 2, 1. The same way, C3 is for 3, 1, D4 for 4, 1. And E5 for 5-1. So in that way, just have a note. It's actually not the part of your answer, but for our facility, we are noting this address of each and every cut point. Now, just project each and every cut point in horizontal way towards the development. See here, strictly you have to use your drafter for this work. Starting from 3-1 dash. I am drawing a horizontal projector. And similarly for 2-1 dash. And for 4 1 dash, and for 1 1 dash, and finally for 5 1 dash. Hale is not enough here now. Approximately I am doing it. Yes. Now, all the projectors of each and every cut points crossing all the longer edges in the development area. But you have to drop a particular cut point in its own place. See, 3 1 dash projector is crossing A1, 2B, 3C, 4D and 5E. Again 1A also, but where you needed to drop this 3 1, 3 1 should be in C3. Okay, 3 1 should be in C3. So the projector of 3 1, where it is intersecting with C3, you have to mark it, and this is nothing but the portion 3 1. In the same way, 2 1's place is 2B, 2 1's address is 2B, there are B2. So here I needed to mark it is 2 1, and the 4 1's address is 4D. Is 4 1, and the 5 1's address is 5E. Here 5 1, sorry, is 5 1, and finally 1 1 address is 1A. Is 1 1. See here, 1 1 need to be marked in two places because 1A is in two places. So you have to mark 1 1 here and there. Is 1 1. Okay. Right. Now what you need to do is you need to connect all the cut points. With a straight line. This is nothing but the boundary. This is nothing but the boundary. In this boundary, below the boundary is the retained portion. Above the boundary is the removed portion. So just leave the portion and the part of the edges above the boundary without darkening. And you have to dark the retained portion of all the edges below the boundary line. Okay. So here you need to dark. Assuming before I drawn everything with the 2H pencil and now only I am doing with the HB pencil, okay. Now this is nothing but the development of the retained portion. Maybe these horizontal projectors disturbing your view. That's why I am insisting use 2H pencil for drawing the projector lines. In your paper, if you do these things with the proper pencil selection for the proper portions, definitely this will look better. Okay. So in this way, you can develop the cut solid, particularly in the case of a prism. For all the prisms, you can follow the same method. Okay. not only for the pentagonal prism. You can follow the same method for square prism, hexagonal prism, triangular prism, whatever it may be. This is what the procedure. Only thing, the number of portion is differ. In the case of the square prism, instead of having 5, you are going to have 4 only. In the case of hexagonal prism, you are going to have 6 segments. So that's the difference between each and every polyhedron in case of development. Rest of the procedure is same. Obtaining the cut points and transferring the cut points to mark in the development area, everything is same. Like this only we are going to do repeatedly for the case of various kind of prisms in your case. But in the case of the cylinder, again you are going to follow the nearly same procedure what you followed for the prism. Okay. In the next class I will give you how to draw the cylinder development when the cylinder is cut by a section plane. Okay. Now in this portion, if you are having any doubt, just ask me. Just to see the work, and if you have any doubt, you can ask. What actually I did here from the beginning is, first I drawn the front and top views of the solid with the given question condition. Here it is actually a pentagonal prism, so the top view is obtained as a base view is obtained in the top view and the lateral view is obtained in the front view. After drawing the simple projection front and top view of the solid, I cut the solid with the given cutting plane. The cutting plane here is perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degree to HP. I cut this solid with the given cutting plane and then marked the cut points in both front and top views. Thereafter I developed the uncut solid portion, lateral portion here. After that, after marking the points in the development also, I transferred the each and every cut points from this top to a front view towards the development area through horizontal projectors and dropped the all cut points in their respective longer edges, and then I connected them. So this is what the work here I followed.